This chapter we will focus on cookies. As we know very well, cookies are the client side information and it is stored inside the client, like user information stored within the client. So in Laravel, the cookies can be retrieved, it can be returned, and it can be customized the way we want to. So that we can start it with just by simply creating a controller, and then I can explain it inside the controller, like how we fetch the values and how we route it to the particular URL. And with the help of getSet methods of the cookies, like we can set the values and we can also get the values which is assigned to the cookie. So let's start by just creating a controller. So let's move to our command prompt over here. I will create a controller. My controller name will be cookie controller. So php artisan, php artisan make controller cookie controller. So the controller has been created successfully. Let's go to our project. So my project is there in C drive, sample project, app, HTTP, controllers. Okay, my cookie controller is created here. I'll open this file. Okay, here I will make the necessary changes. So here I will create a function. So my first function will be for setting up the value in cookie. Setting up value in cookie. Setting up value in cookie is using the set cookie function, which I'll define it right now. Public function set cookie. Okay. Here I will do the necessary things. Set cookie. Here I will take a parameter request. Just go request. I will set the values for the cookies. So the values will be like, what will be the response, what will be the name inside the cookie, and including the minutes. So first I will define a variable named minutes. This will define the expiry of the cookie, for how long the cookie it will be there. Dollar response equal to new response hello world. And inside here, I will specify dollar response with cookie. So what with cookie will give, it will give the values associated with it. So with cookie name, I'll also include a value for it. So my value variable is Omkar. Dollar minutes. Okay. So with cookie includes another function named cookie. So this function is to define the cookie. So it will be like name, the value associated with it, and the number of minutes. So return dollar response. Okay. Now set cookie function has been done. Another is to get cookie. Here I will use a function name for getting cookies, will be similar like this one, like set cookie. It will be public function get cookie. Get cookie. It's not showing capital cookie. Yeah. Here I will say request. Your request. Dollar value equal to dollar request. My value will be dollar request and the name of the cookie. So I will say name. Okay, and here I will print that value. The functionality we will see it when we'll actually route it to a particular URL and check it on our browser. Now let's move on to a routes.php. So the routes.php is already open over here. Here I will define two functions which we want to check it on our URL, that is getSet. So here only I will do it. That is get. First thing will be get. Get will give me the value of cookie underscore set, what value was already been set, and it will be under the cookie controller. And the function name is set cookie. And now the next thing is about another function, which is get cookie. So here I will do same thing, only the parameters will change. Instead of set cookie, it will be get cookie. Okay, so I have done it. I have added the URL also respectively. Now the output will be displayed in the browser. So let's move on to our browser. Here it is. So I will say localhost colon 8000 cookie. Here I'll say set. Okay, HTTP app controller's response not found. So this class must have not been defined. Let's define the particular class. This happens when you have not defined the class and you have not used it in your system. So let's go to our cookie controller. Okay, so it has accepted for request, but it has not done for response. So let's include response class within it. That is done in the similar way over here. Instead of request, I will specify for response. Okay, so it has done. As far as now I can see, everything has been called up. Let's move on to a browser. Let's try to reload. Yes, so it is calling hello world. How come it's calling hello world? You can check it here. I've set the request parameter as new response will be hello world. If I say set, if I do with the set cookie, it should give the output like this. And if I say get, it should give me the output which is assigned to the cookie. So my assigned value was Omkar. So let's check it out. So it's visible. So in this way, Laravel helps with setting and getting up for the cookies. So both the outputs are displayed clearly. Set displays hello world and get displays the output which was assigned to the cookie, whatever the name value which is assigned to the cookie. So this ends with our chapter of how Laravel works with the cookies.